Abraham Lincoln was once quoted as saying, "If you ask me to chop down a tree in 6 hours, I'll spend the first 4 just sharpening the axe." In iconography, as in many things, preparation is key. The Chapel of the Resurrection took a team of 4 iconographers about 8 weeks to complete, and of these, perhaps around 3 of them were simply preparation. The initial thoughts of the board members and the fathers were that we would put an icon of the resurrection, the one that people are most familiar with, on the apse wall, and that might even be it. But quite early on, a suggestion was made that perhaps we might put the more unpredictable and more or less frequently seen icon of the Anastasis, which is Christ ascending into Hades and pulling Adam and Eve up with him to paradise, as well as all the Old Testament prophets. After an initial line drawing was made in pencil, it was coloured so that we could see perhaps what it might look like in full colour. And we mocked it up on the wall, and generally we were quite happy. But we did think, what if we continued all the way around the other walls and even the pillars to create somewhat of an enclosed space that you really sort of feel surrounded in? After the remaining drawings were made, we used a projector to actually project them onto the wall directly. And once on the wall, we spent several days actually just defining and redrawing the lines just to make them as accurate as possible until we were completely happy with them. With the drawings all done, the next thing really is to get the gold leaf on and what we call the base colours, or sometimes we even call it the proplasmos, which means first layer. From that point on, although the piece looks basically finished to most people, it actually takes another 4 to 5 weeks before all the details of all the faces and all the clothing and all the architecture is completely finished and the piece is completed in its entirety for everyone to see. The icons are much more than reminders of historical events. They are opportunities to put yourself in the shoes of the disciples on the boat and be ready to receive a miracle or a calling from Jesus, or to be just like Thomas and have a renewed faith that God fulfills his promises and to put your hands inside his wounds. We really hope you enjoy the Chapel of the Resurrection and that it enriches your spiritual and prayer life. We hope in particular that you try and match the symbols from the New Testament to the Old Testament and see how they really carry through the story of Jesus.